Good day, dear subscribers. Welcome to Digital Science Teacher YouTube channel, where we learn biology, chemistry, and basic science. Today, we'll be looking at reproduction in plants. Come along with me.
Every living organism is capable of producing young ones, which are either the same or somewhat similar to them. Can you guess the name of this process? The process is called reproduction. In a simple term, it is defined as the process in which living organisms give birth to an offspring which is similar or the same. Now, when I say living organism, it should include plants, right? Of course. Now, you have often seen a seed growing into a new plant when it falls into the ground. Have you wondered where these seeds come from? Of course, it comes from some plants. Wait a minute. Have you seen the whole plant produce flowers, fruit, and seed? Not exactly. Some plant does not produce flowers, fruit, or seeds. This plant produce means. Let's answer questions in this video. So, what are the types of reproduction in plants? Reproduction is divided into two parts, which include sexual reproduction and asexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction involves sex cells or gametes. So, a new individual is born when gametes from both male and female parents fuse together. Now, can you guess what asexual reproduction will be? In contrast to the former type, asexual reproduction does not involve gametes. So, a single parent part can develop into a new plant. However, which part of the parent body will grow into a new organism? Based on various conditions, asexual reproduction is further classified into various types. These include the vegetative propagation, fragmentation, budding, and spore formation. We will understand the details of these several types as we go along in this video. But first of all, let's talk about sexual reproduction in plants. Do plants undergo sexual reproduction at all? Of course they do. Plants undergo sexual reproduction using their flowers, which are their reproductive structures. The male part is called the stamen, while the female part of the flower is called a pistil. But how does this process occur? Let's try and understand this. But before that, let's look at the typical structure of a flower. A flower consists of the following parts: the essential part and the non-essential part. What are they? The part of the flower, such as the stamen and the pistil, makes up the essential parts of the flower. They are called essential parts because they are directly involved in the process of reproduction. So, do we mean if these parts are not present in a flower, the plant will not be able to reproduce? Yes, of course, you are correct. But what are other parts of the flower? The non-essential parts of a flower include the petals and the sepals. So, the petals and the sepals are the non-essential part of the flower. They are not directly involved in reproduction. This is why they are called the non-essential parts. Now, let's discuss each of these parts in details. The stamen. The stamen is the male part of the flower. It consists of a long tube, which is called filament, and a swollen stalk called the anther. Do you think this part has specific functions to perform? Yes, of course. The swollen part called anther bear round structures called pollen grains, which plays a very important role in reproduction. It is being transferred from the anther to the female part of the flower. What do you think this female part is called? That will lead us to the next structure, which is the pistil.
The pistil is the female part and it consists of three different structures, which are the stigma, the style, and the ovary. Does this structure have specific functions? Of course, the stigma is the landing point for the pollen grains. So, pollen from the male part is transferred to the stigma in a process called pollination. Next is the style, which is a slender stalk which holds the stigma in place and also connects with the ovary. So, what are the ovary? Ovaries are the swollen base of the pistil. And what is the function? It contains ovules. What is an ovule? The ovule is the female gamete which develops into an embryo. This process is not as simple as it seems. It is a complex process. Let's get to know more about this process of fertilization in our next video.